What up, players? It's WarbossTae up in his mug. Why don't we paint this Word Berries Chaos Space Marine? Khorne Red. Rakarth Flesh Shade. Bugman's Glow. Steel Legion Drab. Leadbelcher. Balthazar Gold. Macragge Blue. Rakarth Flesh. And these aren't in any order, of course, as always. Just whatever I have on the table. Druchii Violet. Mephiston Red. And that's it. So here we've got a Chaos Space Marine, Word Bearer Space Marine, and this is a new conversion I made. I couldn't find the one that I did for the Chop Shop. So I just made a new Chaos Space Marine, and I put a bunch of Purity Seals on him, Khorne Red. So I'll let you know right now that the most of the parts came from the Chaos Space Marine sprue. So if you have the Chaos Space Marine kit, you'll be able to make this model just about. The only things that are different are the head, which is actually from the Chaos Space Marine Terminator kit, and it's got a little bit of a horn thing going and a rebreather, so I thought that was pretty cool. Also, you see those scrolls hanging from the hip, I believe are from the Space Marine character kit. The great thing about Word Bearers is they have lots of purity seals, oops, and parchment and all that kind of stuff, but the difference is that they use them, I guess, to worship the evil dark chaos gods, but you could use the purity seals from the regular Space Marines just to kind of show that they're the mirror opposite of them. And I gotta say, I really did not care for the Word Bearers all that long time ago when I made a Fluff Hunters video on them, but since then I've read, what was it, The First Heretic? I've read everything in the Horus Heresy series of the Word Bearers, and just about. Did not care for Battle for the Abyss, but anything by Aaron Dembski Bowden. Oh man, and I don't want to be like a ADB fanboy, but he really has a knack for making you feel for his characters and giving his characters depth, and especially the evil ones that you don't really get from other writers. Usually anyone who writes the Word Bearers is going to be like, oh, Chaos Gods, oh, they're so good, you don't know anything, Chaos is number one, Chaos for the win, oh, everyone else sucks. And they just sound really whiny and desperate and pathetic and just not fun. But yeah, Aaron Dembski Bowden really gives you a feel for their characters, why they are the way they are, what being raised on their homeworld of Colchis has done to their minds, and combined with the gene seed of their Primarch, how that has affected the way they feel, the way they think, how they feel betrayed by their by the Emperor and by their former brothers, and gives you a reason to maybe you don't like them. I don't think I'll ever really like the Word Bearers because I think they're just so fanatical, but I like how they're portrayed as kind of the mirror opposites of what the Imperium becomes in the 40th millennium. In Warhammer 40k, everybody on the quote-unquote good guys team, the Imperium of Man, Space Marines, even like the Black Templars, are so fanatical and just, you know, crazy about like fascists. Alright, so we're gonna let this dry for a little while and then I'm gonna come back through the magic of film, aka a day later. I think in between these two clips, I just painted and uploaded the whole Servitor series. Okay, Druchii Violet is next. You might ask, okay, why not Agrax Earthshade or Caraburt Crimson? If I was gonna do Blood Angels or World Eaters, something with a nice bright red, then I would do Agrax Earthshade to show a little bit of dirt and grime that you can build up from, or Caraburt Crimson to give it a nice red shade. But Druchii Violet, a purple, when you shade a dark red with a purple, it makes the red actually look darker. And boop, never wants to stay on this thing. Squish them on, WarbossTae. The purple shade is going to just darken that red, give it some really nice natural shading. If I went with known oil, it would be too black. So having a little bit of the color in there is what is going to really make this guy pop. And I know this because some of you might remember I did a mini Word Bearers project back, I think around the time that Nick, that Itik Beer was doing his Terrain Square project. And I did my Chaos Space Marine squad that I was going to put into a little painting competition. I did them up with, I think it was Caraberg Crimson, and the guys that I did after that I really took my time with, I did them up with Druchii Violet, and the Druchii Violet guys turned out to be a lot, they turned out to have a lot more depth to the color. So we're gonna let this dry, and again, shablammo, through the magic of elapsed time and film, we are completely dry, and we're gonna go on to Leadbelcher. Now, you should not be painting from one step to the next. You should really, if you're doing these word bearers, man, go in an assembly line, do whatever you need to do, because you need at least 1 hour. I'd say 2 hours is great for to get from the first step to the second step, because it is just a lot of stuff to get through and to dry, you know, and then you don't want any paint whatsoever or any of that wash color whatsoever in the recesses. It's just not gonna be good. Okay, so the other parts that I use are just purity seals from the Space Marines kit. The Space Marine Commander kit is great because it has those scroll cases. It also has the, I think on the, you'll see on his left, is it his left? Yeah, his left shoulder pad, he's got that little hanging parchment thing with the purity seal on top of that. I think that's from the Space Marine Commander kit as well. And the back banner is actually from the Raven Wing kit, the Raven Wing Knights kit. So I just got it from Bits Order on eBay. Window box, I believe it was. And yeah, it's just, you know, fantastic. I think I got both of the long hanging scrolls, because they're supposed to go on the, you know, the motorcycles for the Raven Wing. But yeah, boy, once you find a use for stuff for these bits, like you can spend a lot of time just digging through the eBay store or the any bit seller, really, Bits Barn, bitsbox.co.uk, and just look for stuff, and just, like, you know, the creative wheels are going to be turning in your head, you know? So, yeah. So as you can see, we're just doing the part of the paint job that I kind of not care for the most, which is the trim of the armor. And one of the reasons why I didn't really care for the Word Bearers color scheme originally was that the silver just seemed to be so bright against the red, and the examples that I'd seen in the White Dwarves of older Word Bearers, the armor was always really red and the silver was always really bright, and it might have been the old heavy metal way, but I remember seeing in an old White Dwarf an army of Word Bearers and just not really caring for it. I think there's a way that you can do it though that will make it stand out and make it look different from your Blood Angels or your World Eaters though, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. I think also the good thing about those two armies is the Blood Angels use like a different trim. I think the World Eaters use like gold trim. And speaking of which though, Blood Angels are coming back out. I might pull out one of the Terminators from Space Hulk and do that next. how to get ready for that, the new Blood Angel stuff. I like to paint these vents in the backpack. And the little rims connecting the vents. I don't know how I got water over there. It's so weird. It kind of bugs me. I was too OCD to wipe it up, though. I really wanted to just continue what I was doing and stay focused. So to get the inside rim, you see that I kind of have to turn the model around on the little cork that he's on, which is why it really helps. If you're not using the cork and you're just kind of gripping it in your hand, you're going to be putting a lot of strain on your wrist when you turn the model around into different places, just to get at the different areas. Also, your knuckles are going to hurt, which is not good also. Okay, so we're getting the trim. You want to get all the little pointed arrow things. On the trim of the shoulder pads. The 8-pointed chaos star on the right shoulder pad. That's something for a long time I didn't know what which shoulder pad had the Legion or chapter insignia, and which had the like the unit designation or the chaos marks, and it's the left shoulder pad, I believe. The left shoulder shoulder pad stays blank, and the right shoulder pad has whatever design you want to give it. So you don't have to do all these little doodads in silver. I like to do it just to show some differentiation on the model. So the thing for any Space Marine that you gotta remember is that even like Chaos Space Marines, Loyalist Space Marines, or regular Space Marines, even Dark Angels, Space Wolves, and Blood Angels, their armor kind of conforms to the same design. And that design is a bunch of different areas where that armor trim comes along, and that's in the shoulder pads, the gauntlets, and the leg armor. So continuing to paint the silver here. If you're Space Marine, and this goes for any Chaos Space Marine, Normal Space Marine, or Loyalist, as it was, if you've got your model's bolter held really tight up against his chest, you're gonna have a little bit of a harder time to paint the chest, the crest eagle for a Loyalist, or these weird arrow symbols for the Chaos Space Marines. So again, having a cork is really gonna help out with that. I have to say, I think this is the leg armor is one of the parts that I find most tedious to paint. So this is the one where I just grit my teeth and just get through it, because it really does make the model stand out. I think you could paint a Space Marine without the leg trim, or a Chaos Space Marine without the leg trim being done, but it really ties together the whole look of the model. It's what people, I think, will... They're not going to consciously notice it, but they're going to definitely notice it if you don't do it. So let's say I painted up the backpack, I did the shoulder pads, I did the gauntlets, and I did the chest. And I decided, you know what, that's it. I'm going to move on to the next one. If I did that, people would notice. No one's going to notice if I do a really good job on the leg armor, though, because it's at the bottom of the model. Their eyes would have to consciously go there. So I think, I don't know, that's just my thoughts on that. I decided to paint the scroll case, for now, silver in Leadbelcher. I might go back and do some details in gold, but I find myself thinking about the Word Bearers as a legion a lot, because they are the de facto bad guys of the Warhammer universe. You mean, you know, without them, the Horus Heresy wouldn't have gotten off the ground, because a lot of the seeds of the Horus Heresy were planted by Lorgar, the Primarch of the Word Bearers, when he sent men into all of the different legions to create warrior lodges. And they were the ones that were kind of subverting the Space Marines in that legion to kind of join this kind of warrior club within the legion that had no rank and that just gathered together to talk about the direction the Great Crusade was going, the policies of the Primarch and the Legion, and without the warrior lodges, which Lorgar and the Word Bearers kind of encouraged and helped to establish, then there wouldn't have been that voice saying, you know, we should really listen to the War Master, because the War Master knows what's going on, and the Emperor, you know, he doesn't really, so we should really... he's not here anymore, he's back on Terra, and he's handing a lot of the power over to these bureaucrats and people who don't know what it's like on the front lines like us. So, I mean, it's interesting, because a lot of these Astartes go into, or Space Marines are Astartes, if you didn't know. They go into these warrior lodges for a noble idea, you know, to encourage fraternity and brotherhood within the army, because they're already in a force of brothers, but these warrior lodges kind of broke down the barriers of rank, and they broke down everything so that you could gather as equals. Okay, Abaddon Black now, while I'm rambling. And the good thing about that, I guess, was that if you were a captain, you could go into a warrior lodge and you could hear the complaints and the thoughts and honest feelings of a private. And the private could, I guess they didn't have privates, but maybe a sergeant or like a regular battle brother. That's what they're called, battle brothers. And they would come in and they would tell you, you know, we don't really care for the way this is run, or we don't really think this is a good idea, because, you know, you don't see this because you're on this side of the battlefield and or on the battle barge, and you're not really in the trenches with us, or for whatever reason. Like, it would be a good way to gain perspective of the way that the Legion is being run. And conversely, on the other hand, if you were just a regular battle brother, you could go and you could hear from your higher ups, even though I don't know if you were supposed to do this or if they were allowed to, but they could hear, you know, why things are being done. We're going to attack this planet because we need this or whatever. Like, by breaking down the barriers of rank and being able to gather as equals, I think the allure was kind of one of transparency. And the only the rule of that was that you couldn't break that tenet. You couldn't go out and spread to the rest of your command or to the rest of your squad what was said in the warrior lodges when you left. I guess it's more for like individual satisfaction. So what I'm doing now is I'm painting Steel Legion drab on the parchment papers, and I think at some point I realize, oh wait a minute, these are word bearers, they're not regular loyalist space marines, they're not gonna have their scripture written on parchment, it's gonna be flayed human flesh, because the word bearers became very much into the occult, ritual, sacrifice. Like almost every story you read about them is one in the heresy where they are trying to put together a sacrifice or research a ritual involving a sacrifice in order to summon or entreat powers from demons. Bugman's Glow, so this is where I decide to go back over it. And the reason for that is because, like, the chaos powers, the mighty ruinous chaos gods, they grant their power through these sacrifices, and they're not good, they're not gentle, peaceful deities, right? They're all about spreading change and discord and chaos, and so sacrifice is like one of their big things, I think, for all of them. A good sacrifice makes them happy. It's like ice cream. I think when you think about it like that, the Warhammer world kind of makes a lot of sense in the Chaos Gods. Like, making a sacrifice is like ringing the doorbell. And you go, the Chaos God Nurgle comes to the door, and, you know, he's not wearing any. He's wearing like his dirty boxers and a dirty wife beater. And he opens the door. It's like, special delivery, Grandpa Nurgle. And he's like, oh? And then he's like, we got you some ice cream, sir.
Like, oh, goody, I love ice cream. What kind of ice cream is it?
And if you sacrifice the peasant, then it's like, it's dirt flavored ice cream.
And like, oh, dang it.
And then if you sacrifice like a planetary governor, then it's like Rocky Road or some Cherries Garcia or some awesome ice cream with like chocolate sprinkles and fruit. And he's like,
oh, this is awesome. Thank you.
Now I want to eat ice cream. So I went to my local game store, and I thought that I could pick up some Tamiya Clear Red to do blood effects. Rakarth Flesh next. But they don't have any. They didn't have Tamiya colors, and they suggested blood for the blood god. But the kind of blood effects that I want to do, like on the edges of these skin parchments, and on the ogre hands, the blood for the blood god is just not, I don't know, if for some reason I like it okay, it works okay, but it's just I'll always prefer it to me a clear red mixed with a little bit of black, a little bit of brown to create that congealing blood look, and that's what I'm always gonna prefer. I don't know if I can't find any, because I think the next store to look for is Game Castle all the way over the bay in San Francisco, so I'm gonna have to hop and skip over the bay to get there. I should probably call. The lady boss and I want to just go on a trip around the area. Okay, here's a handy tip for painting heads, for those of you who are not used to it and you just slap the paint on. If you go from above, like what I'm doing, painting the top of the head, the forehead, and especially if you have a black undercoat, this works really well. If you go from above, painting down,
then there's a better chance of keeping the darker shadowed, I guess like the where the eyes are in shadow, and that'll make it easier for you later on to not have to worry about painting it and shading it down with your washes. So now I'm going to move on to Macragge Blue, because we're going to paint this helmet up as an ultramarine. Classically, in the Horus Heresy and in the fluff, the Word Bearer's arch nemesis are the ultramarines. And so I was looking around for a base color to paint this helmet, and I couldn't remember off the top of my head what I used to paint, or what was the, you know, the order of painting the ultramarines that I painted for my project First Founding, because it was so long ago. So I decided, oh look, Macragge Blue. Macragge is synonymous with ultramarines, so I'm just gonna start with that. If I could go back though, I would really have painted this in Kalidor Sky, because Macragge Blue compared to Kalidor Sky is a lot more muted as a blue. I think the Chaos Space Marine kit was actually, when it was released, one of the first boxed kits. I could be wrong, let me know if you think differently, but the first box kits to really have such a huge amount of extra bits in them that you are probably not going to be able to even use with one box set. Like the amount of extra special weapons they had on the frames, Rakarth Flesh next, and I think the Rakarth Flesh is for the skull, but like on one of the frame, the command part of the frame, you've got all the different icons, right, for the different factions, the different gods. You've got the Plasma, the Melta, the Flamer, I'm trying to remember off the top of my head, plus all of the Chaos God specific heads. Speaking of top of my head, the helmets for the different gods, the Nurgle champion, the Slaanesh champion with the horn, the Tzeentch Chaos Sorcerer head, and the helmet with the Khorne symbol on it. So those represent the four Chaos Gods, and I just think the Chaos Space Marine sprue is so good. That's probably why they're not gonna recut that for a while, because it's functional, it works. And just adding on to that, like with the rumored Chaos Space Marine Havoc Squad, or the Chosen Squad that have been rumored for a long time. Leadbelcher next. So yeah, for those of you who aren't even painting Word Bearers, but are just playing this video just to hang out, have someone to hang out with while you paint, thank you. Thanks for having me on. So the trim of the bolter, or the special detail in the bolter, is what we're doing with this Leadbelcher paint. And I found that for a lot of different legions or armies, where the silver goes is kind of different. Some of them, like the Iron Warriors or another army, have like the majority of the bolter is silver. It's in silver with the details are actually picked out in a different color. Like the plate of the detail is black with the yellow chevrons on it for Iron Warriors. Yeah, so I guess depending on which army you play, your bolter is gonna could look differently. Now, if you're painting your Word Bearer with an enclosed helmet, which most are going to be, unless you're doing a character, then I would just paint the helmet like the rest of the armor.
And I think the eye lenses for the helmet is going to be a dark green. So when you do paint the eye lenses, I would go with a Cabalite green. Or maybe first I would do Caliban green to get that really dark green. And then I think it's Cabalite green that has a little bit of a turquoise hue to it. Abaddon Black next. But shade it again with the Druchii Purple. And pick out the details in black, like the tubing, the grill on the front of the mouth. And you should be fine with the helmet. So now what I'm doing is I'm going back over just areas that, if they're not going to stay black, can go to another color. Like if you had any ammo pouches or anything, we could paint that black for now. We're also going to be painting all the little wires around the armor because we don't want to take away from the red. If I painted like a bright blue or a bright green or another color for the wires, then it would kind of throw off the symmetry of the color scheme, which you could do if you're doing like a crazy Tzeentch themed or Slaanesh themed warband. You could have, you know, a totally contrasting color for the wires coming through the legs and the boots, but I think overall you're going to want to kind of let that be a detail that goes under the radar. You could highlight that black with a gray, but generally I'd leave it. So at this point I'm wondering what color to paint my purity seal, the actual wax that's affixing the seal to the armor. And for other loyalist chapters that have red armor, like the Blood Angels, I'm talking specifically about, you would use like a rich purple, because purple kind of contrasts but still has a very waxy looking feel to it. Generally, for every other chapter, you're going to use the color red, but when you've got a red armored miniature, you're not going to want that. So I decided to go with Mephiston Red because it's a really, really bright red, and it's a good base for highlighting up an even brighter reddish, pink, or orange hue, depending on what we want to go with. But I decided to do that to contrast the dark red of the armor plates. That red, bright red candle wax. Or not candle wax, I'm sorry, but the wax that kind of seals the paper to the armor. Okay, now I'm taking black and I'm painting in the joints of the armor. So my final thoughts on this first part of the video is that I haven't really cared for the word bearers because the original color schemes that I've seen, the red was just so bright. Bright red, silver, didn't really do it for me. But darkening up in this case with the dark red armor, kind of shading to a black or a purple. Khorne Red next. For the islands of the helmet. I think that's the way to go. And I could definitely see having a Chaos Space Marine army in this color. Now, at the end of this video, we're gonna kind of leave it as okay, if you want your Chaos Space Marine to be a Wordbearer Space Marine, then this is a good kind of quality to reach. But to make it really a Wordbearer's army, besides doing the Legion transfer on the left shoulder pad, I think you're gonna really be able to have some fun. Balthazar Gold next. You're gonna really be able to have some fun if you go that extra mile and make it look all cultified and Wordbearers-y. And I'm gonna show you how to do that in the next video. I mean, I'm already doing it with the extra purity seals and scrolls and parchments. But even without that, if you had no purity seals, no parchments, you don't have these kits, and you just want to make your guy look like a word bearer rather than a world eater or something else that uses black or a red, I'm sorry, as a primary color for your armor, then I'm going to teach you how to do that using black to and silver to kind of decorate the armor plates with runes and script and chaos diagrams and stuff like that. So stay tuned for that. Now, if you've got an exposed helmet, this is a great way to make that Rakarth flesh look even more disgusting, is by adding a flesh-colored skin wash. So we're using Raiklin Flesh Shade, and basically what we're doing is we're trying to find the shadows and the grooves. So right at the brow is a good one. Anywhere where the skin touches the apparatus of the helmet is good to have a nice line of shading there. So you can see I'm trying to pull the shading down. On the back, in the back of the head, is another good area to have a little bit of shading to show the contrast from where the light is hitting the top of the head.